Hello friends, welcome to eStudy India. Now, before we begin with a new topic, I want you to please comment in the comment section below any topic which you are facing difficulty with, or if you have any problem with these kind of lectures and you want to convey some message or suggest anything with respect to this, please do comment in the comment section below. Now we are going to start with finite automata. So basically, an automata is a model of computation. Now if you see in this, this is the hierarchy of the model of computation. So it have four classes: type 0, type 1, type 2 and type 3. So this is these are the four classes, and corresponding to these classes we have some language and grammar and automata. So with type, if we start from type 3 class, so type 3 is that class which have regular grammar, regular languages and finite automata. Another we have type 2 language, context free grammar, context free language and push down automata. Then we have type 1 language, which is context sensitive language and linear bound automata. Then is type 0 class, which have an unrestricted grammars, recursive enumerable languages and Turing machine automata. Now we will study these one by one: finite automata, then push down automata, linear bound automata and Turing machine. Now in finite automata, we do not have any storage, any temporary or permanent storage. So in finite automata, those languages or grammars are accepted which do not need any stack or any storage to store the information. Then we have pushdown automata. In pushdown automata, we can accept only those languages or grammars which can be deduced with the storage space of only one stack. Next is linear bounded automata, in which we can deduce those languages for which two stacks can be used. Now in Turing machine automata, there are more variations and much more complex method to accept languages. So these we will study one by one. So we define this model by this diagram. There are very few languages which are accepted by type 3, that is regular language or regular grammar. Then all those languages which are accepted by type 3 are also accepted by type 2, that is context free language. All those languages which are accepted by regular and context-free language are also accepted by context-sensitive languages. And all those languages which are accepted by type 1, that is context-sensitive languages, are also accepted by type 0, that is recursive language. Now type 0, for that we use Turing machine. For type 1, we use linear bounded automata. For type 2, context-free language, we use push down automata, and for type 3 regular language we use finite automata. Now non-finite automata, non-deterministic finite automata and deterministic finite automata. These are the two types of finite automata. Then is non-deterministic push down automata and deterministic push down automata. These are the two types of push down automata. Then we have non-deterministic linear bound automata and deterministic linear bounded automata. These are the two types of linear bounded automata. Then we have non-deterministic Turing machine and deterministic Turing machine. So slowly we will read them one by one. We will study them. Now we will start with finite automata. Now in finite automata, Kleene introduced regular expressions to describe the behavior of finite automata. He also proved that the important theorem saying that regular expressions exactly capture the behaviors of finite automata. Now we will study about the state transitions and finite state transition system.